There are several thousand collisions involving trains each year, which result in over 1,000 injuries and several hundred deaths. A majority of these deaths occur when someone is struck by a train while trespassing on railroad property. Remember, railroad property is private property. Trespassing along railroad property is not only against the law, it's very dangerous. Avoid taking shortcuts. The only safe place to cross railroad tracks is at a designated crossing. Don't get caught dead on the tracks. Stay off, stay away, stay alive.
I want to wish everyone a really warm welcome to the 32nd annual Collage Concert. I'm Erin DeLuga, the principal of York High School, and I'm absolutely honored to open tonight's concert for all of you and to give you a warm welcome. I have to tell you that the size of this crowd is indicative of the support of parents and family members in the community to our fine and performing arts programs. We are so grateful to you. And I can tell you, watching your students perform throughout the building and getting into a lot of classrooms this year, that I am so impressed with the dedication and commitment to fine arts that our students have. As an individual that grew up in a family of performers, artists, dancers, actors, instrumentalists, and vocalists, I want you to know how dedicated I am personally and professionally to fine arts. My most cherished memories include those in choir, in band, playing the piano, singing, playing the drums and percussion. I continue to sing at weddings and to vocally perform. I think it's really because of these engaging experiences that I believe that deep, engaging experiences immerse students into their own intellectual prowess and heightens their overall achievement. The Ignite co-chair, Lucy Liu, explained the value of arts when she stated, "The arts can transform lives. It gives us power to question, to confront, to explore, and to challenge how we think about the world." And I have no doubt that our students before us have found that experience here to be true. So I am so thrilled to witness my first Collage concert and can't wait to celebrate the talent and community and commitment of our incredible staff and students. So now, I'm going to turn over the program, starting with the Advanced Dance and Concert Band Percussion Ensemble's performance of Chris Brooks' Bound for Marrakesh.
Thank you. Travel with me. Good evening. I'm Carol Ruda, and I'm president of the York Music Boosters. And it's always a great start to the school year to hear and see such great performances from our performing arts students. The York Music Boosters serves our students in a variety of ways, including assisting and supporting the performing arts department, facilitating student fundraising activities, and providing enrichment opportunities for our students. Each year, our organization provides thousands of dollars to York students for summer music camps, as well as grants for enrichment activities throughout the year. Last year, we awarded $4,000 in scholarships and grants. We are very fortunate to have so many parents supporting us and our performing arts students. If you have not already become patrons, we encourage you to do so. Your support directly benefits all these York musicians and dancers. You may become a patron by visiting the York web store or by visiting the Music Booster table this evening. If you've already joined and need to pick up a cling or a magnet, you can do so tonight by visiting our table. We will have two fundraisers this year directly enabling students to raise money for trips. First, the green sale will kick off in the coming weeks. And second, we are hosting a pop-up mattress sale on November 13th. Other local performing arts organizations have had great success with this fundraiser. We are excited to launch this new fundraiser and are hopeful that it will be a lucrative way for students to defray the cost of trips. More information about both these fundraisers will be sent home in the coming weeks. Finally, we'll be hosting our annual Barnes & Noble Book Fair on Cyber Monday following Thanksgiving. The proceeds from the book fair help us provide more enrichment opportunities for our students. Information about the Music Boosters, enrichment grants, and scholarships, as well as our fundraisers, can be found on our webpage, linked to York's website under the Parent and Student Resources tab. After this concert this evening, we'll be hosting a reception, and thank you very much. We look forward to a great evening of music.
Oh, Elijah, I'd like to take advantage of a little, just a couple minutes we have here to get our marching band set up. Again, my name is Bill Riddle. I'm the Performing Arts Chairperson, and I know I speak for our entire Performing Arts faculty that we're so fortunate to be able to do what we do. A lot of us say this at every concert because it is true. Very fortunate to be able to work with your children. They teach us just as much as we learn, just as much as they do. And I just, again, am thrilled at the type of, this is my ninth year here at York, and every year I'm just amazed by the support that we get from this community. Now, I live in Elmhurst myself, and I just truly am thankful for that, to work in a school that we have and a community that we have the kind of support for our performing arts program. So give yourselves a hand for the support that you're giving our children. We are also so thrilled to welcome Erin DeLuga as our new principal at York. It's already so apparent to us that she is so supportive of performing arts and fine arts. I did know that she was a former, well, not former, certainly, I think even last spring, a dramatic performer and choral singer, but I was so delighted to find out tonight that she played percussion. Oh my God. We're gonna do something with that as time goes by. So, I also love the fact that she was able to share a little of her history with you. But that, you know, we are thrilled to work with students that are gonna go on in music, become performers, teachers. We also know that the majority of our students are gonna go on and enter the world and maybe do and have a lot of different careers. But we are so happy that music will always be a part of their life. And not only music, dance, art, and that they will see their life for the rest of their lives through that filter. And that's one of the very exciting things that we hope to do as a faculty here at York. Two quick announcements. JR Recording, as always, does an unbelievable job recording all of our concerts. So they are here tonight. Richard Peck, just a phenomenal job. He's the gentleman sitting right over here at the controls. If you wanted to purchase a CD tonight, we can do that over there. They're in your programs, and also all our concerts all year long. We also want to thank Comcast for coming out tonight and doing such an excellent job at filming our concert. I understand this will be all in October, multiple times shown on cable. So thank you so much, Comcast, for that. And then also I would like to thank our custodial staff, who always does such a fabulous job with this huge event. In fact, really our whole faculty has to, yes, let's give a hand to our... As you might imagine, it's not easy not only to logistically put all this together, but our entire faculty is involved with allowing our kids to rehearse today and get out of school, so out of classes, which they were very disappointed about, but I know that it is difficult. And lastly, just to remind you again, we do have a reception in the Commons after this. Again, thank you so much for letting us be with your kids on a daily basis. Thank you. And now the marching band.
Hi, I'm John Quigley, President and CEO of the Elmhurst Chamber of Commerce and Industry. In these challenging economic times, it's imperative that our residents and businesses band together to not only shop Elmhurst, but buy Elmhurst whenever possible. We have great stores in our city center, Spring Road, Butterfield Road, York and Villette Streets, St. Charles and Route 83, North Avenue and Lake Street, along North York and even Grand Avenue. I ask for your help. Let's keep our tax dollars in Elmhurst.